We gather once again in the name of the Lord Jesus, who is present among us as we offer our prayers and thanks to God. Welcome to one and all, and a special welcome to our guest. My name is Tim Reese, and leading us in worship today is Father Mike. In today's gospel, we hear a wonderful story from the Middle East. 10 lepers approach the Lord and ask to be cured and made whole. When they are healed, only one returns to give thanks, a foreigner. This story helps us to focus on the virtue of gratitude, our heart's response to God for the many gifts he has given to us. We begin our celebration with song as we sing, "All People That on Earth Do Dwell," found in your program. But first, let us stand and greet one another as we would greet the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. It's a gorgeous autumn evening. The sun is low in the sky. The air is warm. The breeze is soft. Beautiful evening to offer our praise and thanks to God in this Eucharist. And in the Gospel, we're told a story of gratitude, of humble thanks, wholehearted gratitude to Jesus for his healing love. We sang that his mercy endures from age to age. So let's open our hearts to the tender love and mercy of our God. Lord Jesus, you came offering healing for the diseased and the afflicted. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came offering pardon to the sinner and the distressed. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come with words of everlasting life for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Kings. Naaman went down and plunged into the Jordan 7 times at the word of Elisha, the man of God. His flesh became again like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean of his leprosy. Naaman returned with his whole retinue to the man of God. On his arrival, he stood before Elisha and said, "Now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Please accept a gift from your servant." Elisha replied, "As the Lord lives, whom I serve, I will not take it." And despite Naaman's urging, he still refused. Naaman said, "If you will not accept, please let me, your servant, have 2 mule loads of earth, for I will no longer offer holocaust or sacrifice to any other God except to the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David. Such is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they may obtain the salvation that is in Jesus Christ, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we preserve, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord.
with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord. In the second reading this evening that Kelly read for us, St. Paul writes to Timothy, "The word of God is not chained." He reminds the young preacher that God's word is powerful. It has power to bring believers through suffering. It has power to unite us with Jesus, Jesus' own victory over the grave. As he writes in that saying, in that same reading, "If we have died with him, we shall also live with him." So as we hear the gospel today, God's word through the story of the 10 lepers, it calls us to gratitude, to be mindful that everything is a gift. All life, all healing, love, even our sorrows and difficulties, everything is a gift. And like the grateful Samaritan in the story, we need to come to the feet of Jesus with thankful hearts. There is a line from Father Michael Heher's book, The Lost Art of Walking on Water, that summarizes this for me. He writes, "Life is not what we do, it's what God gives us." While gratitude and thanksgiving is a powerful message in the gospel that we just heard, remember, there's no chaining the word of God. There's all kinds of power here in other messages. And another more subtle message confronts us in the gospel and the first reading, a message of tolerance and openness to strangers and foreigners. St. Luke sets the stage in the very first line of the gospel. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. This is a signal from the gospel writer that Jesus is walking along a border, crossing from one side to another, between two hostile cultures. Jesus is on the edge. He's going to push open some boundary. The gospel writer is preparing us for this, some new understanding. To us, St. Luke could have said, Jesus continued his journey, walking down 8 Mile, visiting neighborhoods on each side of the boulevard. Or, Jesus walked along the Texas-Mexico border, spreading God's love on both sides of the border. Or maybe Jesus would say to us tonight, the gospel writer would say, Jesus sat himself down on a hill between Orion and Oxford. St. Luke is signaling something powerful, that the kingdom of God that Jesus proclaims and establishes embraces people on both sides, embraces all people, all peoples. It tears down walls. Diseases and all that afflicts human beings and divides and separates us, Jesus has come to cure and to heal. In the kingdom, God's love abounds. So in the story of the 10 lepers, who is it that returns to offer thanks and praise to God? It wasn't Jesus' own Jewish brothers, but rather a hated foreigner, the Samaritan, who's overcome with love, who disobeys Jesus, really. The other nine obeyed him and went to the priests, but this foreigner is so overcome with joy and spontaneous love for Jesus that he comes back and throws himself at his feet and offers thanks. Just as in our first reading that recounts the cure of Naaman the Syrian, he was a hated enemy of Israel, a commander in the army that defeated and enslaved Israel. Yet through God's prophet Elisha, he is cleansed of his leprosy. It seems that God does not pay attention to man-made boundaries and divisions. God chooses to love and bring healing wherever and to whomever God wishes. When Jesus cures the 10 lepers with the word of command, he is straddling another boundary, another fence. He is balancing the law on one hand when he commands them to go to priests to declare them clean, and on the other hand, breaking the law when he comes in contact with the diseased lepers who come to him. Jesus opts to show compassion as he heals them, yet he observes the law, as I said, as he sends them to the priests to be declared clean. In the kingdom of God, there's always a tension between the letter of the law and, well, the law of love, God's generous mercy and care. It is a tension that his followers, his disciples, all of us, continue to struggle with, that tension between the letter of the law and the law of love. For example, the church sometimes defies the law in our own country when it shows care for foreigners and undocumented persons on our soil, saying it is better for us to honor the children of God than to obey the law and not help them. Or in the case of respect for life and the lives of the unborn, we stand against the law of the land on behalf of all of God's children. It's the same in other areas too. When church leaders call us to be compassionate to the despised, those segregated and treated as sinners, aid sufferers, prisoners, the poor, the homeless, from whom we often keep our distance. In my ministry as a priest, I sometimes am called upon to walk on the edges, to minister to people who are public or not so public sinners, to proclaim always God's love and mercy. Pope Francis, in the famous now recently published interview, speaks continually about God's love and mercy. He was put on the spot in that interview and asked if he approved of homosexuality. And here I quote the Holy Father. He says, "I replied with another question. Tell me, when God looks at a gay person, does he endorse the existence of this person with love or reject and condemn this person?" We must always consider the person, the Holy Father writes. Here we enter into the mystery of the human being. In life, God accompanies persons, and we must accompany them, starting from their situation. It is necessary to accompany them with mercy. Then a word to priests. When that happens, the Holy Spirit inspires the priest to say the right thing. It's the same attitude of mercy and compassion that motivated a great hero of mine. His name was Joseph de Wooster. He was a Belgian missionary to Hawaii in the 19th century. We know him now as St. Damien of Molokai, who ministered to lepers, and in the process, ministering to lepers in Hawaii, contracted the disease himself. He once wrote home to his family, "I make myself a leper with the lepers to gain all to Christ Jesus." It was love and gratitude that brought the leprous Samaritan foreigner to the feet of Jesus in praise and thanks of God. In spite of what he suffered, he was overwhelmed by love and by the mercy of God. Isn't that what brings us here to the table of the Lord, to this Eucharistic celebration of thanks and praise? Isn't it the love we have for God, and gratitude to God, dependence on the gifts of God and God's mercy? For life is not what we do, it's what God gives us. We profess our belief. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With gratitude for all God's gifts and entrusting our cares and needs to God's mercy, we dare to pray.
Let us pray for the church. God, who heals and makes people whole, be our salvation. Help your church give witness to your mercy and loving kindness towards all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for peace. Bring an end to war, terrorism, and violence, O Lord. Stretch out your saving hand and bring peace to our world. Banish hatred and anti-Semitism from every human heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those in our society who are persecuted. Jesus, you stretch out your hand and lift up every human person. Help us respect the dignity of all those whom society shuns and keeps at a distance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick and the suffering. May your healing spirit enfold our ailing brothers and sisters, Robert Wesley Meldrum, Donald and Sharon McCoy, Tom Berg, Stanley Demolik, Amy McWilliams, Brendan Doyle, Helen Gawney, and Bobby Wood. And for all who have asked for our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. Let our beloved dead who have died with Christ live with him to sing the songs of eternal glory, especially Mark Turner, Carmen Nancet, and the deceased members of the Moloche family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in a moment of silence for our heartfelt needs. Give us thankful hearts, O Lord, and help us to recognize your gifts. May we give thanks each day for the food and life and all your blessings. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, God of creation, in the face of your Son, Jesus, we encounter your mercy, healing, and love. Hear all the needs and prayers that we bring in his name, who is our Lord, living with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings that, through these acts of devotedness, we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he, blessed is he, who comes in the name
Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and grace.
celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Let us pray now to our Heavenly Father, as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to receive my word, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's be seated for the announcement.
In Marion Hall, you will find information and sign-up opportunities for the following activities and groups: the Knights of Columbus Membership Drive, the St. Joe's 40 Days of Life Fall Campaign, and our community outreach project, Extreme Home Makeover. Many hands are needed for this effort. Please also see the Voice for details on the following: the Bravehearts event for men entitled The Women in Our Lives, presented by author Teresa Tamio this Thursday evening, and the upcoming Women at the Well event on October 23rd with Father Mike as the speaker. Finally, please note a correction for the date of the next Widow's Luncheon. The correct date is Tuesday, October 29th, and not this Tuesday.
Thank you, Kelly. My parents are visiting. Had a family wedding this afternoon. We're on our way to the reception. I welcome Mom and Dad here with us. Dad and I have a little difference. He thinks that the Tigers have overvalued Jim Leland, and I think he's a great manager. So there's a game that starts tonight, a series. We'll see if he's a good manager or not. I guess, right, Dad? Good. Let's stand and pray for God's blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. We go now in peace to be God's love and mercy to all we meet.
Thanks be to God.
Awake from your slumber.